Secrets of a Creativity Coach by Eric Maisel. For Anne, 36 years into this adventure. Introduction. I've been coaching creative and performing artists for more than 30 years. I've worked with famous artists and unknown artists, young artists just starting out, and octogenarian artists, full-time artists and artists who in their day jobs are lawyers, government workers, therapists, and blacksmiths. My clients live in the United States, Canada, England, Germany, Iran, Australia, Japan, South Africa, everywhere in the world. We work together via the phone or Skype and via email on all of the issues that creative folks face: survival issues, resistance and blockage, existential sadness, productivity, marketing and promoting, distraction addictions, everything. What do I actually do? How does the coaching work? What do clients present as issues? How do I respond? And what transpires? What really goes on? Although I've written about creativity coaching in several books, I've never been able to show the literal work. I began to wonder if there might be a way to share with readers the actual coaching experience. Then it struck me that a way to present the complete, unvarnished experience did exist. If I limited myself to email coaching, and if I asked clients beforehand if I could share our correspondence verbatim, then a reader would be able to see everything there was to see about how the coaching worked. It would all be there in black and white. A lot of the questions that I am regularly asked about creativity coaching could get answered this way. What was the difference between coaching and therapy? Now a reader could see. A reader could see how in virtually every interaction one could have done therapy and how I coached instead. What do you do when a client presents a wide variety of issues? Now a reader could see. A reader could see how I focused and made choices. What do you do with a frustrated client, a sad client, a blocked client, an overwhelmed client, or an under-motivated client? Now a reader could see. It would all be there, transparent and real. This idea intrigued me, and I invited creative and performing artists who subscribe to my newsletter to embark on this adventure with me. A few hundred came forward. Many had wanted to work with me for the longest time, but hadn't been able to afford my fees. So, this free opportunity delighted them. All had real issues that they wanted help with. No one signed up as a lark or to be part of an experiment. All of them wanted the coaching. Now, how was I going to manage working with a few hundred clients and for free to boot? Had I bitten off more than I could chew? Yet, the challenge excited me. I pushed my worries to the side and began. I used the same basic setup with each client. I invited them to answer three questions about their history, their current challenges, and their goals for the upcoming 2 months. When they replied, I asked a clarifying question or two to help me better understand their situation. When they replied again, I offered them my vision of what they might want to work on for the next 2 weeks, invited them to come to their own conclusions, and asked them to report in 2 weeks. When they reported after 2 weeks, I set them off on the next 3 weeks of work, and so on. That amounted to the entire setup. I immediately learned an interesting thing, that many of the folks who recognized that this was a golden opportunity nevertheless dropped by the wayside. Some dropped out almost immediately. Others got as far as formulating what they wanted to work on for the first 2 weeks and then dropped out without another word or confess that they hadn't accomplished anything and preferred not to continue. Here's how one writer put it. Between the struggling marriage and our displaced life due to the hurricane, I have not been writing. This didn't work for me. It was a great concept, though. In a relatively short period of time, only half the original artists remain. This is important to note, both for students of the creative process and the creative life, and for coaches who want to work with creative and performing artists. Even with no fee, and even with the opportunity to work with a seasoned coach, an artist is entirely likely still not to be able to make use of that opportunity, maybe because of life circumstances, maybe because of a pervasive sense of sadness and defeat, maybe because his current project is too hard, or for any number of other reasons. Naturally, this doesn't all get...
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.